Welcome back once again, Soccer Bites and Narrabet Television. Time to talk about the Nigerian Professional Football League, Week 10, Segun. And we saw how the teams on the continent fared. We had talked about Ifeanyi Ubah losing, you know, and that definitely has plunged them down to 19th on the table. Just same number of points with Remo Stars, who are locked up in what people are terming the battle of the bookies come this weekend, Shooting Stars versus Remo Stars. So here's how the table looks going into week 10. Plateau United still top after 9 games, 20 points. Kenebi Boboye is still doing a very great job, only one loss to Akwa United. El Kanemi are in second, ABS are in third position, a team you love so much, you know, and MFM and Aimba are fourth and fifth respectively. So Shooting Stars, Ifeanyi Ubah and Remo Stars are 17th, 18th, 18th, 19th and 20th respectively going to the next round of matches. And let's take them one at a time. ABS taking on Wiki Tourists. Wiki Tourists seem to have bounced back from the elimination from the Cup. They won in midweek, but they are away at ABS.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a very good game. ABS have been a surprise package for me. We have to remember that it just came up along with Niger Tornadoes and Remo Stars from the
National League.
From the National League, it's four teams that came up.
Yeah, and I think we had
ABS, Niger Tornadoes, Remo.
That should have been Plateau.
Yeah, no Plateau.
ABS, Niger Tornadoes, Katsina.
Katsina United.
That's right.
Yes, Katsina. You know, and yeah, Katsina not doing too badly too, but ABS really, really good. So I'm expecting them to be able to take out Wiki Warriors.
Katsina took out, they took out Ifeanyi Ubah in the midweek. So ABS, you give that one to ABS. Let's look at the MFM and Rangers. That is going down at the, what do they call the Agege Stadium these days? Okay, so it's going down at the Agege Stadium. Rangers, who definitely managed to climb out of bottom position, now in the 17th position.
Rangers were might fortunate against Lobi. They won the game in the 90th minute with the Bobby Clement goal. And another problem I have is Rangers played yesterday and they're playing again tomorrow night. So obviously they're going to field possibly second team in the United States. Don't know why that has to be, but I know they have broadcasting commitments and all. So I think for me, MFM will be heavily favored for this game.
Right, you're saying a win or a draw for MFM, you say?
I'm looking at it, win for MFM.
Win. I think outright win.
An outright win, yes.
Canopillas are at home to Katsina United, who dispatched Ifeanyi Ubah over the weekend. Canopillas were also in action over the weekend, during the midweek as well. They played out a 1-0 draw with Rivers United. So both teams poised to, you know, go all out this weekend.
Well, a very good road point for Canopillas. Apparently, their first point on the road, considering that Rivers United dispatched their Champions League opponent so handily, you would have felt that Canopillas could have been in danger of a tonking, but that wasn't the case. They ground out a well-deserved draw, and I'm sure they'll carry that level of confidence into the next game against Katsina United, who don't travel particularly well. And I'd give all 3 points to Canopillas.
3 points to Canopillas. You put your money on that?
Yes, Canopillas putting that.
All right. Betty puts his money on that. All right. Shooting Stars and Remo Stars, the battle of the bookies, they call it. Shooting Stars are at home. Both teams are struggling this season. It's a tough one, no doubt.
I don't think it's a, I put my money on Shooting Stars. To be honest, I'm not quite happy. I'm not too happy with Remo Stars with the dispense with services of my guy. But even then, apart from that, really, I mean, early in the season, you choose them, their third coach, because they had an interim coach, and then they've now got Fatai, I'm sure.
Yeah, Fatai.
the new coach. I hear he's a good guy. You know, he's
Fatai Omo versus Fatai Ashraf. Two Fatais.
Two Fatais. Then Ashraf is in the battle.
Facing off.
A sports betting company. So, yeah, it should be interesting. But maybe Remo starts away from home, away from, you know, the Shagam Stadium. There'll be less pressure on them. You won't pressure the demanding fans. But then playing in the Adama Sibathesi, I was there a couple of weeks ago when, I think it was at the first game of the season when Shooting Stars beat a heavily favoured Lobi, because I actually thought Lobi was, because Lobi beat them away, you know, that last time, and Shooting Stars were quite solid and competent at home, and so I can't look beyond Shooting Stars taking away.
All right, Shooting Stars, Remo Stars, battle of the Fatais, battle of the sports betting companies, Lobi versus Aimba, very quickly, just... Your pick.
My pick very quickly. Inbox,
home win.
Draw. I'm looking at drawing that.
A draw.
Yeah.
Okay. Ifeanyi Uba, second to bottom on the table, taking on the first place Plateau United. Quickly. Draw.
Draw.
A draw?
Yeah, I think. They were disappointed against Accra United. Right.
Yeah, but they bounced back. They bounced back and they beat Niger Tunnel.
Since then.
2-0.
Yeah, it's a draw. Yeah,
draw. A draw?
Yeah.
Okay. Not a home win for Ifeanyi Uba.
Not a home win.
Okay. Niger Tunnel just take on Gombe United.
Niger Tunnel just win.
Home win. Accra United versus Abia Warriors.
Home win.
Well, my darling Accra United are, you know,
I like Accra United's coach.
We're climbing.
And I think... And that was a very, very competent and very fluid performance against Plateau United. Good performance.
All right, El Kanemi taking on Nasarawa.
El Kanemi, Nasarawa, they always win at home. And this, I'd like to apologize to any of our viewers that went to go and bet based on what I said. Because I said Abia Warriors, El Kanemi was a home banker for her. Because El Kanemi has not won on the road since 2013.
Yeah, 2013.
You know, so fantastic. So,
and that affected, of course, Okeo Medi's job as well. Well, what's the latest on that, though? He said he's quit.
Well, he's quit, but what I hear is that he was slapped. Let me, because I use the word assault, but I hear he was slapped by a fan, which is outrageous and disgraceful.
Interestingly, Kabiru Dogo of Nasarawa United, who played El Kanemi, was also approached, you know, mobbed by fans.
No, they become the players, both players and fans of Nasarawa have been complaining about the lack of security surrounding. And as I said, I blame the club for that. What are they smoking that you allow fans to get into, you know, they should, I don't know,
lack of health. Adequate it's security.
Totally inadequate.
Well, we hear that Kabiru Dogo has rescinded his decision to leave the club. He says he's still with them. He should be with them when El Kanemi, of course, who are coached by Ladambosso, of course, would host them. Sunshine Stars, Rivers.
I'll be at that game. Sunshine Stars have problems. The threats that they might not play, they've not been paid for 7 months. So I'm not sure whether they'll be well motivated. Generally, Akure Township Stadium is a bit of a fortress, but
Rivers are more motivated.
Rivers are much more.
The guys motivated. That went to Spain, the guys
probably,
that
we have multiple psychologically. They've
everything.
They've had a moral boosting win last weekend.
That's right.
So
and right after the win, they were given a brand new boss and a brand new, car. So
let me take that as an away win for Rivers United.
Away win.
Yeah.
Let's see how it goes. Of course, MPFL Match Day 10 beckons. Let's see if Shagun's picks will go your way. All right, don't forget www.narabet.com is a place to be.